the entire congregation to kneel, except in those in the balcony, for prayer.
Said, "Dr. Spence, you may not know this," and he gave me a little of a background for the performers that solo pieces I did today. And when I heard that, it gave me a commitment to want to be associated with Columbia New College. Let me pick in Mr. Grant, for example. He gave me the background of Miss Grant, and he said to me, "She is performing at the doctoral level." This is Columbia Community College. I'd like to join with our college pastor, our senior college pastor, Pastor Charles Stack, and our provost, in welcoming everyone to this auspicious celebration this weekend. Just a quick reminder also that on page 23 of your program, you'll notice a new item we've added this year, a President's Reception. That is for faculty, staff, graduates, and their families. See page 23 for additional details. Graduates, you're in for a treat this morning. You see, you came here to Columbia Union College, a college that is a learning community committed to the Seventh-day Adventist Christian vision of excellence and service. This cosmopolitan institution challenges students to seize the opportunities for learning in the nation's capital in order to become the moral leaders in communities throughout the world. I'm excited about your aim. Be the change you want to see in the world. You're in for a treat. Our baccalaureate speaker today is the 2008 Woman of Distinction. Dr. Williams received this auspicious recognition from the California Legislative Assembly for her years of dedicated community service in the San Bernardino County. A graduate of Boston University's School of Theology in 1998 with a Doctor of Ministry degree, Dr. Williams received her Master of Divinity from Andrews University Theological Seminar in 1989. But the best of it all is this. She also holds a Baccalaureate of Arts in Theology from Columbia University. An internationally acclaimed author, Dr. Williams is a successful minister of the gospel, an in-demand preacher, teacher, counselor, whose ministry crosses various racial and religious boundaries. Her many accomplishments and awards include the distinction of being a recipient of the prestigious fellowship in 1996 from the Episcopal College of Preachers, National Cathedral here in Washington, D.C. Alumni of the Year, 2000, Andrews University. The Association of Adventist Women and North American Division Women's Ministries Woman of the Year in 1995. Dr. Williams' influence is profoundly felt around the world with countless participants who have been healed through her ministry. She has touched the lives of millions through her books, preaching, and groundbreaking counseling and widely applauded television series. Graduates of 2009, get ready. Dr. Williams will talk to you today about get out of the boat. Before she comes to you, we will have our scripture lesson and an anthem. Dr. Williams, welcome home.
Disciples get into the boat and go on ahead to the other side while he dismissed the people. When the crowd disappeared, he climbed the mountain so he could be by himself and pray. He stayed there alone late in the night. Meanwhile, the boat was far out to the sea. When the wind came up against them, they were battered by the waves. At about 4 o'clock in the morning, Jesus came toward them, walking on the water.
When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I, don't be afraid."
Peter, suddenly bold, said, "Master, if it's really you, called me to come out to you on the water. He said, come ahead.
But then he saw the wind. He was afraid and, beginning to sink, cried out, Lord, save me. Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. You have little faith, he said. Why did you doubt? And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. And those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, truly, you are the Son of God.
This is the word of the Lord.